I don't want to state the obvious, but it's been quite a year.
Yeah, it was scary.
So personally, the beginning of the pandemic felt like a train hit our household.
My husband and my two young boys, all of us at home, having to change the internet plan because the bandwidth was not enough.
What if there's an extended lockdown? Do I have the resources I need? Does my family have it? Does my community have it?
The need for strong civil society organizations at the local level was more critical than ever.
70% of the population relies on daily wages in terms of them going to work and in some instances, life and death.
1 week we were in the office and the next week we were locked in our houses.
A lot of the Japanese NPOs or NGOs are in shock.
We've all had to change the way that we work.
We had to shut down the office on Friday, and a nonprofit called us on Monday and said, I have everything at the office, the server, the files, the emails, because they were not in the cloud. Everything was at the office. Probably they were saying, yes, we'll leave the technology investments for later. Later is that the pandemic came.
We started with the most basics, food.
Food insecurity became a big issue.
We also went into supporting organizations who didn't have the technology tools, making sure that they have things like airtime just to make calls, laptops, because again, most of them had desktops. Because of the lockdown, they were not able to access their offices.
How can we keep a community running or keep a community alive when all we have is this?
The demand for the program skyrocketed. It was like the nonprofits that we serve realized during one weekend that they needed to move to the cloud, that their technology investments were not enough before the pandemic.
And what we saw across the network happening is people just turned on everything they had for the community.
Having people with different perspectives be able to dialogue together was, I think, an important source of support to provide the community.
We never thought of ourselves as a frontline organization when disaster strikes, and this was a unique situation in which infrastructure was actually the front line of response.
And we got to spend and focus time with organizations who were doing things on the ground to really make a difference. And personally, that was really validating.
When people talk about organizations thriving, they're serving more people than they ever have before. They're doing more of this than they ever have before. This is because more people are hungry than have been before. And more people are sick than have been before. And there are all these students that aren't going to school. They're not thriving. They're doing what nonprofits do, which is they're showing up for their communities in all the ways that they know how.